So PTS just got changed, and PTS number 1 and 2 were complete shit. And these are the newest changes. I think these are the best changes going into the, PTS number 3 for season 2. And I'm really excited, and I have with me Kiki and Cyclone Spin, my teammates, and basically we're gonna talk about the changes. So let's see, new conquest. Further refinements to conquest have been made, and we improved collision paths. Okay, that's cool. Player spawn should now display correct god icons and pantheon flags. Does it actually show the pantheon flags, Kiki? Do you even know?
I have no idea, dude.
I don't think I've ever seen it or even cared about it enough.
That's exactly what I feel.
Various performance relation. Okay, optimizations. That's good because I was actually dropping frames. Like, didn't you say you were dropping frames as
Yeah,
well?
that's why I didn't want to play.
Okay, so attack speed buff now adds 15 magical power from basic attacks, 12 physical power from basic attacks, in addition to 15% attack speed. Okay, so I personally think that's gonna be overpowered, at least for early game. Actually, it may not be overpowered. It might be just a minor thing. What do you think, Cyclone? I don't know.
Trying to mine it.
Like, would you see, yourself going for that buff over, like, let's say, speed buff, like later in the game, or no? Probably not, right?
It depends on which
I feel
god.
like earlier in the game would be really good, but later it doesn't really have that much impact.
It literally depends on which god.
Yeah, I mean, I know for a fact I'm gonna get it a ton, but I don't
I mean, give it
know.
to me on Arachne, though, so.
I know, yeah, right? That would be gross. So, let's see. Camp spawns, fixed increased leeching mechanics. Jungle mobs are not correctly retargeted with the valid. Blah, blah, blah. Okay, so they fixed the bullshit where the mob would like be invulnerable while I was.
Reset.
Yeah, I hated that shit.
Hallelujah. Oh my
Reset when
god.
like I'm still in range, you know?
Okay, I
Yeah,
mean
like
was
it was so dumb.
that was like more of an expected change. This jungle camp buff was kind of unexpected. So hopefully, I think they're trying to add more physical power, magical power to people that have weaker clear. I don't actually know how that's gonna help out too much, but I mean it's nice. You get like actual physical power, magical power. It puts a little bit more value on purple buff. You don't want to lose it now, or else like, because what I'm thinking in lane, let's say the other dual lane invades your purple buff, well now you lose your 12 physical power or 15 magic power and attack speed, which honestly is probably huge for the lane. That probably mean winning or losing the fucking lane. So, all right, this is huge. Mid harpy camps. These camps are now on a delayed spawn. They first appeared 3 minutes in the game. What does that do to your lane, Cyclone? Like, does that, because I know you guys like invade mid harpies or have to start mid harpies. What does that do? Do you guys just start speed to blue every single time now, or what?
You can do that, or you can start, back camps and go to speed and blue. Or you can just flat out invade them like everyone normally does.
Just flat out invade. Do you
Yeah.
think there'll be less invades with mid harpies not being there?
No.
I think it opens up more time because you don't need to worry about the harpies for the first,
Yeah.
for a few minutes of the game.
And what does that do for mid? Like, where do you start now? Because usually mid starts at mid harpies, like every single game, right? So
Yeah.
where do you start? Do you just do back harpies? Do you YOLO? Do you leech off speed or some shit?
Yeah, I feel like you're gonna be either you could even help out the solo and jungle now. There's gonna be a lot of different like rotations now. It's interesting.
Okay. And do you think early game mid gods are gonna be more important with this? Because now the first set of mid harpies are even more important, just because like
Yeah.
he's gonna.
First set of mid harps means you just play cheesy crap and just snowball out of control.
Okay.
Pretty
Like
much.
Isis OP? Okay.
Yes.
Alright, and the lane mechanics, the time to earn rewards from tagging damaging minions have been reduced from 10 seconds to 5 seconds. So, do you think last hitting is going to be even more important, even in the mid lane, Kiki? Like, because I know, for example, when I play mid, like, if
Yeah.
I notice the mid laner cannot fight me and there's no jungler to be found, I'll just last hit mid like an asshole. Like, do you
Oh
think
yeah,
that'll be
like I
important?
learned that from solo lane, so I'm kind of like bringing it in the middle.
Yeah.
I feel like 5 seconds is usually enough, though. The 5 seconds that's left. So I'm not sure.
And obviously, that'll probably set up ganks more in each lane. Like, I know for me, when I'm last hitting, I'll have the other guy, like, just sitting back, losing out. Like, especially in duel lane, because it's so fucking long. So, if I last hit, and they're not gonna get anything. It'll cause pressure in itself, especially if they can't fight me. So, do you think, like, for example, Cyclone, if you were the last hit in solo lane, just because you picked the better matchup, which is so important for solo, do you think that is absolutely crucial, like, to last hit, just so you can knock out, like, the, any experience the enemy laner would get? Like, do you think that would just, like, auto-win the lane for you?
Yeah, and you can also, you know, just bully them out of lane and just shove it into tower to get, like, rotations as yeah. well.
Okay. A chili spear. Was this item even in the last fucking PTS? Yeah.
No, it was so bad, no one picked it up.
Okay, I didn't even notice, because, like, I never ever picked up. Do you actually think it's going to be good now? What do you think, Kiki?
I don't know, it's really risky, because you take increased damage. So, like, if you're going to be using an active like that, that's so, like, high risk, high reward.
What was the original active thing? Like, what did it say?
No movement speed.
And so it's like, it's 30% attack, it was 25% attack speed, 25% increased lifesteal, and you take like 33% extra damage or something like that.
What the hell? Did you even experiment? I know I didn't experiment with that. Did you even touch it or not really?
I tried it once the first game of PTS, and I was like, why would I buy this?
Oh, okay. Cyclone, did you ever get this fucking active?
No, it's such a terrible active in every way possible.
So it branches off of Sprint 1, so you would have to replace Sprint 1 for this.
Just take out Sprint entirely in Heavenly for this item.
Do you think it's a good replacement for Sprint or no?
No, because... Well, it still has the same thing, right, where you take increased damage.
Do you think this would be good for AD carries? Like...
No, you take increased damage.
Because you take increased damage.
Yeah, okay.
Like, sure, like, maybe if you time it, like, right...
Yeah, like, let's say I gas pedal with Apollo, my passive is up, and I just fucking Gatling gun people with the spear. Do you think that would be worth it, or is it still too risky going into mid to late game? Probably too risky, right?
Probably too risky. Maybe if you have an afro, who knows, that'll be a thing.
Yeah, okay. Bloodforge, this item is actually going to be bought now, because actually... is a reasonable amount of money. Even though it got nerfed, do you think it'll actually be used, Cyclone? I mean, I personally don't think... maybe I could get it if I want extra lifesteal, because extra lifesteal has kind of been key lately to even to survive in lane. But what do you think, Cyclone? Would this be an item to pick up at all?
It's better than Devil before you max stacks Devil.
Okay, so like... So, like, if you knew you couldn't stack, you would get this if you needed lifesteal?
Yeah, just get it. If you, like, you're like Shablanki or Huyi, who can't clear to save their lives, you just get the item.
Do you think Transcendence to, like, a Bloodforge would be an actual thing?
Transcendence Aussie is better.
Okay, fair enough.
You think so? Because they added Pen onto Ichival, so that has Pen, and then you lose the Pen from Aussie, but you get Bloodforge. I don't know.
I'm not even too sure. I'd probably have to test this item just to see where I would put it. Because the question is, at least for a dual lane, do I get it after Devo? Do I not get Devo? Do I get something else and get lifesteal later with like ASI plus Bloodforge combo, which would be a nasty amount of lifesteal, pen, and attack speed? And also I get the physical power from Bloodforge? Or do I just fucking forget about it altogether? I don't actually know. And then Blue Storm Pendant, is it worth ever getting this item, Cyclone?
Yes, if you're mana hungry. Basically, it's for hunters. If you're just mana hungry.
No.
AMC boy?
Yeah, AMC. Yeah, I don't know, because, like, it does give the MP5, but, like, I didn't even get it previously. Like, I think that was maybe too tiny of a nerf. But MP5 is nice. I'll tinker around with it. I mean, there's still the question is if hunters are actually going to be fucking useful. I wouldn't even know.
Yeah.
And charge bow. Now triggers lightning every fourth hit instead of randomly, reduce attack speed from 25% to 20%, reduce the cost to 1,200. Is that actually a thing, Kiki? Because you love anything with bows. would that be a thing for you?
It makes it more reliable. So I see what they're trying to do. They're trying to give hunters clear from auto as opposed to like abilities.
Yeah, charge bow actually might be used a ton. I wouldn't be surprised. I might try it out on like.
That would be really interesting.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
What is if you ever play X-Ball?
I want to. I just wish it wasn't poop. I mean, they did buff. We didn't go over that yet. So, charge Morningstar. Added 4 plus MP5 to this item. So, much better, right? Like, do you think they're just trying to help? Like, if you go into charge Morningstar to whatever the fuck it builds to, Heartseeker or Transcendence, I forgot. Do you think they're just trying to make it so your laning phase isn't as shit? Like, they're trying to help you out sustain more? If you get this item instead of, like, let's say, Devo Gloves? Is that the dream?
Yeah, pretty much. You just want to clear.
No, I'm saying, like, if I were to go charge Morningstar, right? Do you think they're trying to make this a viable option instead of just going default Devo gloves every game? Just because you play Hunter
charge
as well?
Transcendence is actually a broken edit now.
Yeah, yeah.
They made it so you get MP5 again, which is basically what happened before, and this price is still stripped, like, to a lower cost, so why wouldn't you buy the item now?
Okay. So you play, like, Hunters in the Soul Lane. What would be your general item build? Would it be into a Transcendence now, especially with
Death
the change?
Toll, Transcendence, Boots, Aussie, Executioner. Basically the same, standard build.
Okay. So Transcendence for sure, even over Death Toll. Like Death Toll and shit.
No, just get Death Toll and
I mean, not Death Toll, Diva Gloves. Yeah.
Yeah. Because, you know, math shows that Aussie actually out-DPSs Devo because of attack speed.
Mm-hmm. Okay, fair enough. And then obviously Death's Toll got buffed, so with Mankind Scepter gone, Death's Toll is the automatic go-to, which it's nice because you have increased health sustain, but they decreased the mana gain. So what they're trying to do, at least but what it looks like, is make Bluestone Pendant more of, like, if you want mana, you go for this. If you want health sustain, you go for Death's Toll. I think the default is always going to be Death's Toll, just because it's so good with the health gain. That kind of early life steal is generally pretty good. Fist of the Gods, the changes from last PTS were fully reverted, which I would assume means that Fist of the Gods still fucking overpowered. Is everyone going to pick it up? Kiki, you going to pick it up, right?
No.
I'm messing with you.
But if I would get Hog, I would get it.
Okay.
Back to normal.
And Psycho, would you get this on most of your Warriors or whatever you would pick it up on?
Yeah, basically.
Do you think that's going to be a problem, that Fist of God is going to be, like, back to normal? Or do you think they just didn't want to see four regular hogs? They'd just rather see Fist of the Gods. Do you think that's, like, a thing, Kiki? Wait, where they're just like oh, no
were
more four hogs.
Were people actually buying Fist of the Gods? Like, what was just...
No, it was never
rank
bought.
One, right?
Yeah. People would just get rank three hog, and objective confirms were fucking a bitch. So.
Yeah, exactly. That's why.
Mm. All right. Greater Purification reverted change to beads from last PTS. It made the following change: cooldown reduction reduced from 5 seconds to 3 seconds. So beads are overpowered again. However, they reduced the cooldown reduction, so you're not immune for 10 million years, just 5 million years. So is that good, Cyclone, going into team fights? Is that, like, actually, like, the automatic go-to again? Because I know beads were overpowered on live. Like, they're absolutely the most broken thing. Like, everyone should get beads or Aegis because they're both amazing as actives. Mm. Do you think it's the same way again, or do you think it's not as important?
Yeah, it's still the same. 3 seconds, you know, it's worse than 5, but, like, it's still cooldown reduction on your abilities.
Yeah, so I'm pretty sure everyone's going to pick that up again. Especially you, Kiki, right? That's, like, the go-to.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure you see most mid laners probably rush that. And then, like, get a second active, whether it be, like, Heavenly Agility or Aegis.
Yeah.
Hydra's Lament, fix an issue with the next successful attack not working properly, fix an issue with damage not being 25%+. Okay. Hydra's Star, fix an issue with the next successful attack not working properly, okay. Lotus Crown, blah, 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 blah. Passive has been changed. Any god affected by your heals gain 20 physical and magical protection for 5 seconds, cannot be cast on the same target again for 10 seconds, but it costs 2100. Is this an item to ever look at, Cyclone, for, like, healers?
I've never used that item in my life. That
What was the passive before? Was it actually the same thing?
I think
it was only
fizz.
Physical.
Yeah, I think it was just fizz power.
Okay. So, is this... Are they trying to make, like, maybe healer supports or healer solos viable? Is this... What do you think, Kiki? Like, what,
well,
if
I mean,
you got this on
you
Afro...
You really don't
want to
run mages in solo right now, I believe. Right, Cyclone?
Yeah.
Because that's pretty tricky in a snowball effect. So, I don't know, maybe Chang'e middle? I don't know what they're thinking. Hell middle?
Do you think this would be a possible support pickup?
I think it's sort of magics, right?
I believe it's a magic
item. It's a magic item, so I don't think it would be.
So there's, like, no magic healer you really want to run?
Yeah.
Okay. Maybe Sylvanas, right? That would be the only one.
Oh,
Sylvanas is dead.
Sylvanas is dead. We'll go over
Sylvanas that. Sylvanas is dead. Rip the
we'll
fucking
see.
Dream.
Rip, man, concepted the dream. Good night.
Thank you.
It was very nice having you for the short period of
time.
No. Mad Guy's Blessing cost increased from 2100 to 2250. Okay. So, is this the go-to item for every game again, or do you not pick this up? Or is this a situational pickup like it's supposed to be, Cyclone?
It's very situational. You
It's not like
basically
go-to anymore.
no.
You don't think, like, for example, you know how supports on live, like, after Sovereignty, like, you. 9 times out of 10, like, you generally just went Magus Blessing because there was so much CC. Like, you didn't even think twice about it. Do you think that'll be a thing? Or do you.
Actually, it probably will be a thing for supports,
Just because
just
of the
so they can
bubble?
confirm Hog.
Yeah, okay. Fair enough. But for
Just
everyone else,
come.
it's situational. All
Yeah.
right.
You can always combine it with,
I think that's good, though.
reinforced
Reinforced
greaves.
greaves, yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Magi's Cloak, remove crowd control reduction from this item. Okay. Ninja Tabby, decrease physical power from 30 to plus 20. But remove the cooldown reduction from this item and added 15 attack speed. How does this affect gods that. Like, for example, alright, in the last PCS change, I know everyone was just running full CDR because you pretty much had to because War Tabby was butt. And it was pretty much guaranteed you're going to get full CDR if you just go into Jotun's Wrath. So everyone, like, cool ability-based gods were out of control. Like Hercules, Nemesis, Odin, you have your ult up, like, every 30 seconds or some shit. So, Kiki, would you ever pick up Ninja Tabby ever again?
I'm glad they removed that. Honestly, those boots, they're just hideous, so I hated building them. And now that they have attack speed instead of cooldown reduction, I really don't see why you'll get them over Warrior Tabby or Reinforced.
Okay. There's not even like one guy in the game. You like for example, Cyclone, you play Bakasora, you play like attack speed gods. Just is there one god you can think of right now you pick Ninja Tabby on? With the added attack
Osiris.
speed. Osiris? Okay.
That's it.
That's it? Just
Osiris.
Osiris? Just because he
Just
benefits?
Osiris.
Yeah, fair enough.
Yeah, just Osiris.
I mean, granted, you could build fucking anything on Osiris and it'd still be good, so
Yeah, pretty
I
much.
think that's okay. So you got one use from it. So Ninja Tabby's dead, essentially from this, especially with the
Tabby.
physical power nerf.
Yeah.
All right, Odyssey Bow now triggers lightning every fourth hit instead of randomly. Price reduced from 2650 to 2450. Is this item real? Go, Cyclone. Is this item the truth?
Late game item is the truth, because it's the proc is so good in team fights.
Is it really? It's like a chain lightning, right?
Yeah, the proc is super good in late game.
So, what would stop me from getting this item, like last item on a hunter? Like for example, I go Devo, Warrior Tabby, Executioner, Kins into Titan's Bane. Why would I get this last? For extra attack speed or just the lightning proc? Is that good?
The lightning proc's just amazing all around.
Okay. How much does it usually hit for? I actually don't know the numbers.
I think it's like 130 late game.
But it triggers like a lot because you'll have attack speed capped, right?
Yeah, basically.
And is that a substantial DPS gain or is that like it adds a little bit to your DPS but it's not like broken by any means.
It's not really broken. It's just pretty strong game.
Okay. Do you guys know the stats on the Odyssey Bow? I actually don't know by heart. Like, does it give penetration?
No, that's it. It's
No.
attack speed and
Pure
mana
attack
proc.
speed.
Pure attack speed? Okay.
It's 40% attack speed.
So would this be more of a last item build if you went for the traditional hunter build? Like, for example, with Rage got its attack speed taken away. So the general hunter build would be Devo Gloves, Warrior Tabby into Executioner to Rage to Deathbringer. Would that be even better for a last item just because it's pure attack speed? So it helps considering the only attack speed item you'll have at that point is Warrior Tabby. So would it help in that regard?
Yeah. Wait,
Okay.
did you say Titan's Bane?
No, I'm talking about like the traditional with Deathbringer or Rage. You know how like Rage doesn't give attack speed anymore, so you only have like
Yeah.
Executioner for attack speed. So, I mean, I might try it. I don't know if I really just have to test it out. I mean, I like how it's cheaper. That's really nice. Considering it was just like flat attack speed and chain lightning, like I didn't
Yeah.
want to buy it because I was like, yeah, chain lightning isn't that cool. I don't know. I played WoW, so fuck that. Polynomicon fixed an issue. Okay. Runic Shield passive aura has been changed. All enemies within range 55 have their magical power reduced by 50. Is this the fucking truth item of time? Like, is this it? Is this how you counter OP mages? And it
Well, it
reduces
was really
magical
good.
protection from 70 to 50. So, like, they change. I like the change they did before. Like, Runic Shield, the last PTS test was basically Magical broken. Witchblade. Yeah, it was broken. Magical Witchblade. Just Freya, Alquang, Kronos, GG, right? So, yeah. Kiki, what the fuck?
It annoyed me.
It did it, really?
Yeah, because, like, attack speed and magical power, the protection is reduced by... it was too good.
Yeah, fair enough. Okay. I know I built this a ton. Like, I love this. I love the old item, but I might have to try this new one for sure. I mean, I don't see myself on a Hunter getting it. Maybe on a Warrior I would get it. Cyclone's had EBRB, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so... I'll ask him later whenever he gets back. Shield of the Underworld, passive change upon activation, reflect 40% of all damage you take before mitigations for the next 5 seconds back to its owner as magical damage. While this is active, enemies cannot lifesteal from you. Is this worth getting? Like, this is an active, I would assume.
Most overpowered active in the game.
Is it actually?
Is this the overpowered active in the game. It's the truth. It's holy shit, that item's the truth.
So, who would you get it on? Would you get it on a warrior or everyone?
A lot of people.
Zhongkui,
for
instance. Yeah, it's just a Zhongkui item. Would this be possible to test with Kiki going into, like... because, obviously, you're the Zhongkui god. So, would, like, your middle lane expertise, like Arachne, Zhongkui, you have Ra, would all those be good to pick up, like... this item on, like, for example, a typical Zhongkui build, you would probably get beads and Shield of the Underworld. Would that be a thing?
It's possible. I had to test it since it's magical damage and not true damage anymore, which it was true damage before, but after mitigations.
Yeah.
So they buffed it and nerfed it at the same time. It'll be interesting to see how it works.
You can literally get it on Herc and never die.
Yeah, this is probably a good Herc active for sure. Okay. Shoes of the Mad Guy got buffed. It's just a flat buff. Increased magical power from 50 to 65, but it still costs... It's dirt cheap. Is it the truth? You get it first, immediately, right, Kiki? Like, absolutely.
No, you get it. I think it's 50 gold more?
Is it 50 gold more?
Yeah,
doesn't say.
I think they're 50 gold more than the CDR boots.
Oh. Okay.
So it still depends. I mean, sure, it's still missing that pen, but some gods you really don't really, like, want full CDR on.
Okay.
So getting that would be better.
Yeah, just because that's flat, like 15 more magical power.
Yeah.
Alright, fair enough. And Smithy's Hammer, cost increase from 1050 to 1300. How happy are you, Cyclone? How happy? Smithy's Hammer is just way more expensive. Do you think that's the solution?
You can't do some retarded build where you can go full tank now.
So I couldn't just start this and go into Witchblade and be like invincible, basically, because it would take too long?
No, more like they did it to stop solo laners, basically.
From getting Hog and Smithy's Hammer at the same time?
Yeah, you have to sacrifice Hog or you have to go Smithy's 1, right?
Yeah.
So that's going to stop a lot of the solo lane starts, which overall I think is a good thing because it'll promote more building
it'll
less tanky
aggressive
and aggressive
play, yeah. Like really aggressive death toll build.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. So I'm sure you're happy. Spirit Robe decreased physical and magic protections from 45 to 40. Why was Spirit Robe nerfed, Cyclone? Do you actually know? I have no fucking... I don't even know that item
was
built.
Really, that item actually was overpowered.
Really?
Yes.
So...
It was 45-45, CDR.
Jeez.
And it's passive.
And the passive,
retarded.
Yeah.
So you think they just tuned it down a little bit with all the item changes? They're like, they looked it over and they're like, Spirit Robe could become overpowered. Let's just tune it down real quick so people never look at it. Do you think that's what they're going for? Or is
no,
this
they just need to tone it down so it wasn't an auto-buy on people.
Okay, fair enough. Do you think it's still a situational item? Or do you think the nerf was very, it didn't really mean anything?
It doesn't really mean anything.
Okay, fair enough. Soulstone got removed. The item
Ciao.
Sucked. Sovereignty, increased physical protection from 30 to 55. Kiki, I mean, at least for me, I think Sovereignty is going to be auto-buy again, but Kiki, what do you think? Like, is this auto-buy for support
good
again?
Like, one time I bought it and it felt like I was still squishy. I was like, why did I buy this item?
Yeah, I didn't really
do that'll
much.
Probably give it what it needs, yeah.
Okay. So, now the aura, didn't they nerf the aura from last PTS? So
yeah,
what does the aura give right now?
Magic protection now instead of Wait, is it
and
magic?
HP, it gives magic like 20 magic protection, yeah. Like 20 HP 5.
And HP 5.
So what gives physical protection? Nothing?
The magic
Heartward
amulet.
The one,
version?
The one yeah. I've been saying is overpowered.
Okay, Heartward amulet. Okay. So do you think people would build this first more magical team comps? Like, for example, if we went like four magic, do you think you'd see more teams pick this up?
The Sovereignty or the Heartward?
Sovereignty.
Probably not,
okay. Temporal Purification got removed, goodbye. Transcendence added 6 MP5s to this item, so we talked about that. Transcendence the Truth. Warlock Sash reverted, Warlock Sash every game, right, Kiki?
Yes, the early game helps again.
Okay, so Warlock Sash still the go-to item since live. A Watcher's Glyph, the passive item have been changed, being within range, being 60 of a minion death without dealing the killing blow awards 4 plus bonus gold, 10 health, and 5 mana. Is Watcher's Glyph the truth? Do you pick it up? Or you just go Mark of the Vanguard? Because I know Incom is getting Mark of the Vanguard. Is this actually a good change? Cyclone Swim, what do you think?
I literally have no idea.
Same.
Yeah. Okay, I know,
don't
like,
play support.
Yeah, live Watcher's Glyph, so I know for a fact it gave, like, extra GP5, which is why a lot of supports would get it, which is because you have an extra gold per minute on top of Midas Boots. So the combo usually was Midas Boots gave 3 gold per minute, or gold per 5, and Watcher's Glyph gave an additional gold per 5. So you'd have 4 gold per 5 minutes, right? Or like 4 extra gold. I think it was per 5 seconds. I don't actually know. Whatever, right? So it basically just gave more gold per whatever, right? And that was why Watcher's Glyph was OP. They took out Midas Boots. Now Watcher's Glyph is in the state of, it wants to give more bonus gold on death, which is cool. Like, for example, if you're just there and you don't get a killing blow, you get more bonus gold, you get health and mana. So it has sustain there, which is nice. So, like, if you just play passive in a lane, and like, let's say you get poked out, you can sustain a little bit better with the 10 health and 5 mana every single time the person gets a killing blow, and also gives 4 bonus gold, but is that really worth it? Like, because you could just forget about this item going into mid to late game. Is it worth the 800 gold to spend, Kiki? Like, do you think that's actually a thing?
Is it worth, like, giving up the aggressiveness with Mark of the Vanguard? Because they buff that item. They give it 50 more health, which is pretty good.
Yeah. Like,
is it worth it?
OP? I don't know.
Yeah.
I think that's more of an in-con question, but it's not actually here. So, no biggie.
I feel like if you lose the lane anyway, and you just want to, like, play passive, maybe you could do that and just farm it up, but you know, you could miss out on a lot from that.
Yeah.
Or you could just stay relatively tanky.
Yeah.
Witchblade, this item no longer provides movement speed. Best item in the game or not? What do you think, Cyclone? Do you pick it up every game or what?
No.
It's not like last BTS where it was first item on everybody, or...
It's just situational now. It hurts some gods, but not that much.
Would you see this more on Assassin still, like in the jungle, just because it gives physical protection? It still reduces attack speed, which is still valuable, and it gives attack speed, right? So,
and it still reduces physical power, right, I think?
Yeah, I think it still reduces physical power. Mm-hmm. So for it not having movement speed, do you still see a lot of people picking this up, or what?
Yeah, but not, like, early.
Not to the degree that it was before.
Yeah.
Okay.
Last time it was basically Instabot.
Yeah, hands down. And then Ward's Habit Tier 3 got buffed. Increased physical power from 30 to 40. Removed the attack speed from this item. Do you get it over Ninja Tabby? What do you think, Kiki?
I prefer physical power opposed to attack speed, so yeah.
Okay, and Cyclone, do you get this before Ninja Tabby every single time?
Yes, except for Osiris.
Yeah, okay, fair enough.
They're trying to make it so that 20 Fizz Power equals 15% attack speed. Which is, like, the dumbest thing I've ever heard.
I don't know.
It works on some gods.
Yeah.
It only works on Osiris.
See, I'm just confused because, so they're taking out all the other bonuses, like the attack speed and stuff like that, and just making it flat physical power. So hopefully they can compensate with more attack speed items. But going into god balance updates and fixes, so at least we pretty much knew from the last PTS, right? Hunters were dead. They're absolutely just, you don't pick them. I mean, maybe for solo lane, like, Cyclone would tinker around with them, but it wasn't really confirmed yet that Hunters were the go-to at all. Like, there's no point of picking a Hunter, so there's no point of ever looking at them. So, with all the changes, as you can see, pretty much they just buffed attack speed, base attack speed all around, and they, like, you know, fixed the items. Maybe hunters be a little bit more viable, so you actually have to test that. So Muzan Kab, base attack speed increased from 0.92 to 95. Attack speed increased. So my opinion is Muzan Kab is going to be even better now because the attack speed per level increase is going to be huge. Do you think you would actually see this in Soul Lane Cyclone? Do you think this would be a thing again or not really?
Probably if
not.
I was good at AMC, it would be
You're not
nice.
Good at AMC?
No.
I always see, like, troll Soul Laners pick AMC solo. I'm just like, what the fuck? So I just assumed you would know. On her, same thing. I don't know. Like, on her, still going to have a weak laning phase for sure, even
He's
with this.
He's better than Apollo, at least.
Yeah, he'll be better than Apollo, I would say. Apollo got the same treatment. He's still going to have a hard time in lane. Because, yeah, like, the biggest thing with all these attack speed changes is that you still have warriors and mages that can full clear the lane. So I don't know, maybe they can farm a little bit better, but they're still going to get outpushed. So you really have to value, is getting outpushed for the first, like, forever, actually, because you don't actually ever get clear with some of these guys. Like, for example, Apollo will never be able to full clear ever in a game. So is that worth compared to a warrior that can full clear the whole time? Like, if I go Herc and I just full clear Apollo every single time, is that actually worth? Because Apollo's still not even going to be able to get his rotations off. He's going to have to deal with the whole wave. Is that a valuable thing? AMC can full clear, so he might be a little bit more valuable off this. This will help him boxing as well, for sure. And if I go double lifesteal builds with AMC, which is Diva Gloves to ASI, I'll be able to sustain a lot, especially if I max Hives out second. So that might help AMC become viable, but I don't see it becoming a thing for Onher Apollo. Would you ever see yourself running Apollo solo ever again, Cyclone?
No, not until his clear is actually decent.
Yeah, I think that's the same thing with Artemis. She got a small buff from this, but she's still probably dead. Cost way too much mana. Kronos, they just fixed his thing not reducing enemy attack speed. Would you ever run Kronos mid, Kiki? Would that be a thing?
Yeah, because they stopped his 3 from getting countered by slow immunity, which is a stun, which was a silly, like, you know, mechanic.
Yeah.
So I think he's pretty good now.
Would you value him high on mid or not really?
Not that high, no, because he still has, like, kind of poor clear.
Yeah. I might run Kronos a lot. I know Cyclone loves Kronos. We'll see. Cupid, small buff. I think that, like, Cupid's still going to be really good as far as, like, cheesing the lane. He can get some early kills, but I don't really see him being a huge pick. I still see myself picking a warrior over Cupid. Huyi, same thing. Kokkan. Whirlwind, fixed whirlwind damage over time, still lasting 2 seconds instead of 2.5 seconds. Fixed description still saying damage over time lasts 2 seconds. So, apparently it wasn't fixed, Kiki, and the damage was
so
only 2
seconds.
That's
why I sucked
at him. Yeah, so is it, do you think the 2.5, you think the 0.5 is worth picking him again? Obviously his ult is still overpowered. Yeah. His slow and his one poke is still obnoxious. He's still slow forever. Is his whirlwind fixed? Can you full clear? Can you set up cool things? Can you zone people
I
out?
I think so, yeah. Is I think it? It'll be worth tinkering around. Like, before you used that extra second gun, it really showed and your clear was just not worth it. So now he should be okay.
Okay. Neith, base attack speed, which is actually really good for Neith because she's, like, an ability-based hunter. She might be viable again, but probably not a carry, like, which would really suck. So usually, at least for in the competitive scene, team compositions are built with having Neith as the supporting hunter, not so much a carry role. So usually when you pick Neith, she was more of, like, setting up things, not so much cleaning up or, like, you know, killing everybody. Like, that's not really in her job description, just because her abilities fall off and her auto attacks were really slow going into mid to late game, so she couldn't really hyper carry by any means. She was more of, like, I root everybody, I have a global stun. So you might see a little bit more of her, but not really, just because of the way her kit is designed. Osiris, Judgment Tether, fix an issue with healing and mana receive not applying to its owner. Osiris not being nerfed, do you think that's a problem, Cyclone?
Not really. They did take out Mannequin, which was pretty huge for him. They also nerfed Witchblade and Runeforge, so he can't feel, like, super tanky. So he's going to be a little bit more squishier to deal with.
Do you think his 3 is still a little bit too obnoxious or strong?
It's obnoxious, but it's, you know, doable.
And what about his reapplying slows? Is that, like, still a problem? Like, for some gods, they just can't get away.
That's a biggest problem he has right now with this kit.
Yeah, with the reapply slow.
Like, reduce the reapply slow, like, actual slow, because it's, like, 40%.
Okay. Fair enough. Rama, same thing. I don't really, like, see him being too much better off. Maybe. I'll have to play with it a little bit. Sylvanas, all right, so this is a huge one. So, the death of Sylvanas. Wisp, this ability now only affects gods. Why is this such a big deal, Kiki?
Well, he had, like, really strong cleric, because he could, at the same time, damage the creeps and heal his creeps and give them, like, protections. And now he only heals gods. I'm just surprised.
Yeah. I mean, I think generally this is a good change, because overall, like, Sylvanas would just auto win every single clear war. Like, generally, at least for dual lane push, it was who can clear the fastest, and Sylvanas would auto win because he would heal his creeps and destroy the enemy creeps by himself. Like, he didn't really need too much help. So maybe this puts him in line with other supports as far as the pushing goes. I mean, he still was really overpowered mid to late game with his setups and stuff like that, but his laning phase is going to be significantly weaker because he's going to be just literally auto attacks during laning phase and sustain. That's literally his job. He's like a magical support as far as I'm concerned, with just a lot of tankiness. He still has kill setups with his root and his pull, but do you think there's obviously no hope of this guy being picked in other roles, right, Cyclone? You're never gonna pick Sylvanas, yeah.
Never again.
So, yeah, I think you might see less of him, but I think he's still gonna be good. I don't know, because his AoE knockup is still, like, valuable. What do you think?
You kind of just sit there and die. No.
You think so? You think it's just gonna
knockup
be like
is the best CC in the game, probably.
Yeah, you know? It is, but, like, in lane, you're just gonna get focused and die. Mm-hmm. There's nothing to stop them.
So kill lanes are gonna be even more dominant. You can't, like, first pick Sylvanas and get away with it, basically.
You can't even, like, pick Sylvanas until, like, counter pick.
Yeah.
Very situational pick.
Okay. Uller basic attack speed increased from 92 to 95. Uller's still gonna have problems. Shibalanke base attack speed increased to 1. I don't even know why they even give. I mean, that's good. I like the attack speed buff on everybody, but I just hope it still doesn't fix certain hunter problems. And I guess the main problem is that if I can full clear the wave at level 3 as Hercules, or I can full clear the wave with Osiris at, like, level 3, why do I pick a hunter? And that's the real question, right? So, I mean, that was pretty good. We went over the patch notes, so if you guys have any questions or whatever, feel free to comment on the YouTube video. I can reply, or tweet me on Twitter. I'll put it down there, and I'll put Cyclone and Kiki's Twitter in the description. And yeah, that'll probably be the end of that. I'll talk to you guys later.
Peace.